Let's open our heart to the living God. Every one of us, you that are on YouTube, you that are present here praying with us, all over the world, let us open our hearts. Let us humble ourselves. Let's lay down everything in our lives to God. Let's ask God to take over our mind and thoughts. We surrender everything that has affected our hearts and minds over the years that is a hindrance to the anointing of God. We lay down these things once and for all. We cast down every stronghold, every imagination and thought. We lay our burdens and we lay it at your feet on the cross of Jesus Christ. Transform our hearts as we consecrate and dedicate ourselves completely to you in our hearts and our minds, that you can quicken our mortal body. You can quicken our thoughts and imagination. And God, that you let not our circumstance overwhelm us and we lay these burdens and these things that overwhelms us and all the things that cause us to carry the burden and labor that we have in our hearts. Hallelujah. We come to you and come all of you that are labored, heavy laden. We lay down every heavy laden burden from our mind and thoughts, and we ask you to wash it away from our hearts and bring that, sanctify and remove it and cast it into the sea, that we be released from those things from within, be healed from within, and yielding to the strength and the power and authority of your Holy Spirit and the anointing of Christ, breaking every carnal concept of our imaginations and feelings and emotions, bring it into total captivity, that we yield to the truth of God and the power of your Holy Spirit, that you take over now. Quicken my mortal body. quicken my every thought. Liporubo sika rabasai. Hallelujah. Not by mind, nor by power, but by the Spirit.
Stand in the gap for the people of this world.
as you were laying down your life and giving yourself to die on the cross. You carried our sorrows, you carried our burdens, you carry our weaknesses, you carry our iniquities and sins. You was wounded for our transgression, you were bruised for our iniquities. And by your very stripes we are healed by the grace of God, and we yield to that grace and to that power. As we lay our lives and surrender our lives to the Holy Spirit, come and quicken us this night. Come and fill us this night. Come and lead us, O God. Anoint us, O God. Hallelujah. Hold on us, sweet and on our side. We just love you, hallelujah. We yield to your everlasting love. We come into the length and the height and the width and the love of God that passes all understanding. We pray, God, that you will hear our prayer. We pray, God, that you touch every soul of every heart of every mind. As everyone is drawing nigh to God this night all over the world, hallelujah. We pray, God, the breakthrough in our church, in our members, in our hearts, in our lives. Let there be such a breakthrough and a manifestation, hallelujah, as we yield to the Holy Ghost and find. Give courage and confidence to your people to continue to be faithful and continue to humble themselves as they draw nigh to you, as you draw nigh to them. Hallelujah. Let us all dwell and abide in your love as you abide in us with your love. Let us become one, Father. United to become one with your Spirit, where you become the Lord of our lives, the head of the church. You become the one who carries our hearts and minds this time. We yield to your life and let us come into that unity and humbleness and continue to release your word to us each week till Christ is born in our hearts, till we come into the full stature of the Lord Jesus Christ, so we can walk in your holiness, your compassion and your love. That you mortify the deeds of our flesh, that we can yield to the Holy Ghost and fire. We can obey you with all our heart, mind, and soul. Hold on the seed and on the other side. Hold on the seed and on the Holy Spirit. come and wash us and renew us in your precious blood. Come and quicken us now, Father. We ask in Jesus' name. Pula namasita niya. Peace and my anointing and my spirit shall lead you and guide continually as you abide, as you dwell in my spirit. For I am in charge of your life. I shall go before you, and I shall build my church, and I shall bring my body into submission to my grace and my truth. They will hearken unto my voice, for I will speak into their hearts. I will reveal to them my plan and my purpose, and I shall go before them continually, and I shall lead and guide you by my spirit. I shall look after your needs. I shall provide for everything you have need of, physically, spiritually, emotionally, even financially. My God shall supply all your needs according to his riches and glory. I will bless thee because of your faithfulness and obedience. I will bless you because your heart desires to serve me and to follow me with all your heart. And I will lead you by my spirit into that place I have chosen. And I will become real to you, and I will cause my grace to grow within you till you become one with me. Yield to my spirit tonight. Let my spirit fill you. Fill you with the Holy Ghost of God. Jesus. Holy Father, just fill us with God. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Oh, Father, everything is in your hands. Everything is in your hands this night. I am going before you. You shall trust me. I am leading and guiding you and filling you with my glory. Holy Father, Holy Father, hallelujah. Let not your heart be troubled, and be not afraid of what man shall say, but hear what my Spirit says to you in your heart. For I will speak to you by my Spirit, and you will know that what I am saying, and I'm leading and guiding, you will know how I will do it. Oh, namaste. Hallelujah, namaste. Hallelujah, Messiah. For you have not chosen me, but I have chosen you. And I have ordained you that you should go forth and bring forth fruit, so that your fruit shall be made. I have chosen you before the foundation of the world that you should be holy, blameless, in the midst of this crooked generation. That you will shine my light and my word and my Spirit. And the people will be drawn by my Spirit to come to this place as I prepare in their hearts to be saved and healed and delivered and set free, which I have chosen already, and I have prepared it by my Spirit, that they will find a resting place in my Spirit as they have come to the end of themselves. My plans will be unfolding before their lives, and I will raise them up for this last day, said the Lord. Hear me, my children. Yield to me, my children. Worship me. And love me with all your hearts. Let my love come alive in you so you can love others with the same love that I love them with. Let my love flow through your mind, through your words, and go before us by the grace of God. And I shall lead you and guide you, and you shall know that I am the Lord thy God, and I change not. For I have many things to tell you and to share and to speak to you. And I will reveal those things as you draw nigh to me. And I will speak to you what you need to know them and to hear them, so you will know where I am with you. Hallelujah, Cassandra, the Messiah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Holy Father, hallelujah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Praise God, we just want to, God will bless you all. Let you know that Jesus is alive. And we pray that God will bless you in everything you put your hands to. Hallelujah. As you continue to pray and seek my face, and please seek the face of the Lord, He will draw you nigh into the very presence of the Almighty God. And God will bless His people, and He will heal His people, He will restore His people, He will open the greatness of His fellowship of His Spirit into our lives, and we shall give Him all the glory in Jesus' name. Amen. We thank you, Father. God bless you.